I'm at Red Hat. I really fit in here nicely. And we're going to talk about what kind of support Red Hat has for IoT. How easy is it to take an IoT sensor and connect it to the network? Here we see in a setup, a track and trace setup with a board, which actually is made from Samsung. And it connects to a little sensor, which basically is in the box. And we first have the box closed. And then we can see here on the sensor deck, now there's light, but at the next thing, there's no light. So, and we're gonna see if you open up the box, the light's coming in, the temperature, and immediately you see the sensors coming up, you see where it is, you see all the tracking and tracing information in there. Now, how difficult is it to put something like this together? So, here we have Benjamin Cape, and where you work for Red Hat, or where do you work for?
I do not. I'm with the Eclipse Foundation.
So what is the Eclipse Foundation?
So we are an open source community, and we have a lot of projects around IoT.
Okay. Describe what we see here. We have this board here, and what runs on this board?
So that would be running Linux and Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Oh, actually, no, that's Fedora that's running on there. And on top of that, we have a middleware, an open source middleware for IoT called Eclipse Cura.
Cura. Here you see Cura. And that's a free version, and you basically run on top of it, and that makes it very easy to connect to all kinds of sensors of humidity, place, etc.
Yeah, exactly. It provides all the APIs for integrating with sensors over Modbus, CAN bus, whichever protocol you want to use, and provides all the abstraction for the communication with the cloud. Right? You want to push data to your cloud so that it's stored and you can access it over APIs. So Cura can help you with that as well.
Okay. And what runs in the cloud? Because it needs to connect to somewhere.
Exactly. So the cloud is Eclipse Kapua. So that's also an open source project from the Eclipse community. And this is basically all the microservices that you require for data storage, device management, software provisioning. And this is what we've been using here.
But then on the cloud, you have Kapua. And Kapua is the core platform which basically receives all this information, right?
Yeah, exactly. And once the data is in the Kapua platform, it's being made available over REST API so that people can build their own applications. And so the example here is a very simple web dashboard that you've shown just before that takes the data straight off Kapua and shows the data, shows all the alerts if there's like too much light like we've seen before. So that's
And is this the security, is that also included? Is there some kind of a VPN from every kind of sensor to the cloud to wherever?
Yeah, so with Cura, you can. There's several security features. You can suddenly hook up Cura to your VPN. There's also some features for doing code signing. For example, you don't want people to be able to deploy code in the field that's not yours. So you can also set up some PKI infrastructures for doing just that. And of course, the communication channel between the gateway and the cloud is secured using TLS and all kinds of security standards.
Okay. So what is the price of all this open software and to run it into the cloud, for example? If you want to run a Kapua on the cloud, how much do you pay for that?
Well, that really depends on how much devices you are expecting to connect and which provider you're using. But you can start with a very simple server, a very simple box for, I wouldn't even know how much, but like a very simple server would be able to run Kapua and connect tens, hundreds of devices. And if you want to scale, then you will need to basically buy more instances, and you can really easily scale by using something like Red Hat OpenShift, right? You can operate the platform. This is all Docker containers, so you can easily fire up new containers if you need more storage, more...
But I mean, how much is more? Because it runs, I mean, I can basically get an instance from this on Amazon, right?
Yep.
So I can run a server for, you know, like 50 euros, 70 euros a month.
Yep.
And then if I want to run this on top of it, would you be running 100 euro plus $1 per device per month? Or what kind of pricing am I looking at?
Okay, so if that's the question, then the answer is zero. The pricing is, I mean, this is an open source platform, right? So you can, for whichever device that you're going to connect, this is your platform. You're operating it. You're in charge of all deploying all the
microservices. Then it's for free. And if I want it as a managed service,
you can get a managed OpenShift instance from Red Hat or that kind of stuff, and you can certainly check that out.
Yeah. And what kind of pricing am I looking at if I have a managed service?
I have no idea, actually.
You have no idea. He's from the free, the Innovation Frog Community Collaboration. It's extremely easy to start using your own track and trace and your own IoT application. Thank you.